This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com and the Adrenal Fatigue Center. Today we're going to talk about an important issue with the female, that is, how are female hormones connected to adrenal fatigue? Now, female hormones are mostly regulated by what we call the estrogen and progesterone. The estrogen balance is in particularly very critical to be maintained at the proper levels at all time. Now, estrogen, as we all know, is a female hormone, but actually it has a group of hormones. There are E1, E2, and E3, and collectively they are known as the estrogen family. Now, estrogen are made actually in three places in the body: the ovaries, the fat cells, and the adrenal glands. Now, in the adrenal glands, estrogen is a precursor to progesterone, which is an opposing member of the hormones in the female family. Now, if you have under stress, then the body's adrenal glands are kicked into action. Now, stress can come from emotional as well as physical causes. In fact, we have even shown that caffeine can stimulate estrogen increased production in the adrenal glands. So, the more stressful your life is, the more hard the adrenal has to work. The adrenals work hard to reduce stress by making a hormone called cortisol. And the precursor to cortisol is progesterone. And the precursor to progesterone is actually within a pathway that includes estrogen to a certain degree. So what we understand now is that estrogen balance is critical in a healthy body. And it's very common in adrenal fatigue not to have this balance, because the progesterone, just being the precursor to the cortisol, is oftentimes shunted. And therefore, the progesterone level in the body drops. And when the progesterone level drops, the estrogen becomes unopposed. Without an opposing progesterone, the estrogen effect becomes more dominant, resulting in symptoms such as PMS, dysmenorrhea, or pain in the period, PCOS issues, fibrocystic breast diseases, endometriosis, as well as certain types of cancer in advanced cases. So when you have a lot of stress in your system, physical or emotional, you can expect that there will be a situation of increased estrogen. And we talked about the symptoms earlier. So it is very important for the female to keep the stress level under control. And because once the estrogen level comes down, then many of the symptoms will go away. Now, remember, estrogen is also tied in to other hormonal systems in the body, such as the ovarian system, as well as the thyroid system. So once the estrogen are imbalanced, the adrenal will be imbalanced as well. And it will drag the thyroid as well as the other parts of the body down. A low-functioning adrenals, for example, will lead to symptoms of low thyroid function. So if you don't want to have low thyroid function, which can lead to weight gain, low metabolism, dry skin, losing of the eyebrows, lashes, and even hair falling off, then you want to maintain a thyroid balance that is well controlled. And that starts with a strong adrenal glands. Oftentimes, this connection is lost, and doctors would just simply give thyroid replacement as well as miss the adrenal picture altogether. So it's very important to understand that the healthy adrenal is a key to well-balanced estrogen. And a woman with well-balanced estrogen and progesterone is going to be a happy woman. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I have written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.